Hey there, I'm Eric, and I'm one of the contributors to Sequin. Sequin is the easiest way to send changes from Postgres to anywhere, and one of the destinations we can send it to is trigger.dev. In this tutorial, we're going to show you how to set up Sequin to execute a trigger.dev task. First things first, why would you even want to do this? Well, almost every task you're going to run in trigger.dev, it coincides with some sort of change to data in a database. It might be a new user coming in and needing to send them an email or enrich their data. It might be a new post getting published and needing to create embeddings for it. Or it could be a new order coming in and needing to fan out work across other jobs. Sequin makes it really easy to transactionally enqueue those changes from your database and immediately execute that task in trigger.dev. What do we have already set up? Well, I already have a database, and here we're using Neon. And there's two tables in there. We have a posts table and a post embeddings. Because in this example, we are going to be taking in any new post or updated post. We're going to generate an embedding and then add that embedding to this post embeddings table. And we also have this database already connected into Sequin. We'll walk through that in our guide. And I already have a simple Next.js project set up with trigger initialized in it. So I already have my trigger directory, and in that directory, I've created a function called create embeddings. So what we want to happen is anytime a new post is created or updated in our table, we want it to execute this task on trigger.dev, which is going to take in that payload of the data changed in the post, which happens right here. Then it's going to turn that post into an embedding using OpenAI. Then it's going to upsert that embedding into that post embeddings table, and it uses this upsert embedding helper function, which we've defined over here as a utility function. And once that completes, the task will just return the embedding, and we'll know everything's working great. So we have this task defined. Now let's get it loaded into trigger.dev. So when I go over to trigger.dev, it's going to give me this helpful command called dev, which is how the CLI is going to basically register that function. Great. So they got the worker ready. So when I go over here, I already have the create embedding for post task ready to go. Now that we have that set up, we want to execute this task by basically sending a webhook to an endpoint that's going to trigger the task. We've created an API directory, a create embedding for post directory, and that creates our API route. And in here, we're creating a post endpoint that Sequin can post its payload to. And that function is going to do two things. First, we have some authorization here. It's going to check an authorization header to make sure that this request is coming from Sequin. And then it takes in that payload and runs a tasks.trigger, which kicks off that create embedding for post task we've already defined and passes in the payload. And then it returns whatever the response is from the handler. So what's really nice there is if the handle picks up the task and runs, it's going to return a 200. If there's any other type of error there, it's going to return that error straight to Sequin. And we will try again. So this all together sets up a route. It sets up a call that triggers the create embedding for post task. And then that's going to kick off trigger.dev to do the work. Now in a new terminal, let's get the Next.js app running. So it's npm run dev. Perfect. So we have everything set up between trigger.dev and our Next.js app. So now we just have to get Sequin going. And as I mentioned, we've already connected into our Neon database. So we have those two tables. We want to connect Sequin to our local Next.js endpoint. So to do that, we're going to create an endpoint here. We'll call it Eric local. I'm going to use a local host because we want to connect to the endpoint that's running locally, and it's going to give me some commands to run that are going to create a tunnel with the Sequin CLI to that endpoint. So first, we'll run Sequin context add. Perfect. And now I'm going to create that tunnel. And so to create the tunnel, we're just going to run this command here, which is sequin tunnel. And as I can see over here, we're running on port 3000. So I just want to update this to run on port, this command to be, to open up port 3000. Great. So now there's a tunnel set up between the Sequin cloud environment and my local machine so that Sequin can actually trigger the localhost 3000 port. Great. So let me go back over to Sequin. Now, the only other thing we need to do here is we want to add an encryption header. I'm going to create a header here, authorization. Perfect. So now we're going to create our Sequin consumer. And I'll go click create consumer, and we're going to connect to that posts table because we want every new post or updated post to trigger. And we want to do a rows consumer. That's because first we want to process every row in the table, all the historic ones and all the future ones. We also want to ensure that every update gets processed, and we're not very concerned with deletes. So it'll be really helpful to be able to do backfills and rewinds. So we want to do a rows consumer here. Now we're going to select the table, the column to sort by. We'll do updated at, and we'll start at the beginning of the table. We can also add filters. We don't need one of those for now. And we're going to do a push consumer so that we send that post request. That looks great. And we will do that local endpoint. Now we need to set the exact endpoint it should call. So we know that it's API. And if we go back to our project, it's really under API create embedding for post, right? That looks right. So we'll create the consumer. Now we're seeing that it's processing the history, and you'll see it's already processed three messages. And that's because we already had three posts in the table. If we go look at the messages, it looks like all three were processed. If we go back into our application, we'll see that there were three calls. They were all successful. They made three triggers that were successful. And if we look back in trigger, we will do the runs, and we see three runs were successful. Beautiful layout here. And when we go look at the actual table in Neon, we now have some embeddings. Really nice. Now, if I change something, right? If I make all of these by me, we go back over to Sequin. We'll see that immediately made a new message. And when we go back, you see that it re-triggered the task. So everything is flowing end to end. This use case with trigger.dev is really popular. So we wanted to create this video, and we just see so much great use cases here, and we're really excited. So you can find us on GitHub. Add any issues, comments, send us a note. We're just building Sequin every day and shipping new features. So we'd love to hear from you. Thanks so much. Bye.